بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، أخذنا في الدرس الماضي ما يتعلق بالصلاة، ذكرنا أن الصلاة تنقسم إلى قسمين، فريضة ونافلة. قلنا لابد لصحة الصلاة لابد من الاتيان بالشروط والأركان والواجبات، وتنتفي عنك الموانع حتى تكون الصلاة صحيحة بإذن الله. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. وبعد، then previously we studied the prayer and we said that the prayer is of two types, that which is an obligation and those prayers which are voluntary. And we said for any prayer to be accepted, you have to fulfill the conditions, the pillars, the obligations, and also you have to make sure that you don't do those things which invalidate your prayer.
نعم. أما ما يتعلق بصفة صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، الأصل أن يكتب شروط الصلاة: استقبل القبلة، اتخذ سترة، أقل ما يقال في السترة أنها سنة مؤكدة. نعم.
So in terms of the description of the complete prayer, then the asl is that a person should pray as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed. So a person should face the qibla and he should also take a sutra, i.e. an object which is in front of him.
يرفع اليدين حذو الأذنين محاذاة الأذنين أو المنكبين.
A person then, after standing in front of a sutra, and this is a sunnah muakkada, emphasized sunnah, then a person raises his hands to the level of his shoulders or the level of his ears. Raises his hands to the level of his shoulders or ears.
يضم الأصابع.
And he keeps the fingers together.
يجعل باطن الكفين متجه بها للقبلة محاذاة حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين. نعم.
And a person makes sure that his palms, they are facing the qibla and that they are at the level of his shoulders or his ears.
ثم يضع باطن كفه اليمنى على هذا المفصل الذي تراه هنا، مفصل الكف، يضع هكذا وضع على صدره، أو يقبض قبض هكذا على صدره. نعم.
And then a person, he places the palm of his right hand on the wrist of his left hand, or he can place it like this, or he holds the wrist with his right hand.
يضعهما على صدره دون تكلف، لأن بعض الناس يتكلف يرفع هكذا أو يضع على قلبه أو على خاصرته أو على السترة أو تحت السترة أو لا يقبض يديه أصلا. نعم.
And then a person places his or her hands on the chest, and he does this without being extreme, because some people they place their hands right at the top over here, and some right down below, and some towards the left side on their heart, and some on their wrist. So a person places it on his chest without going to extremes.
ثم يقرأ دعاء الاستفتاح.
And then a person recites the dua al-istiftah.
وهو أن يقول سبحانك اللهم، وهو أن يقول.
And this is for a person to say, and the sheikh will recite.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. أو غير هذا من أدعية الاستفتاح الواردة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So a person can say this supplication when starting the prayer, or the other supplications or the remembrances which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to mention.
ثم يستعيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه، أو أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه. نعم، يستعيد بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. نعم.
And then a person seeks refuge in Allah.
ثم يقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And then mentions the name of Allah by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
يقرأ الفاتحة كاملة.
And then a person recites the Fatiha, all of it.
مرتبة.
As we mentioned, in the right sequence.
بآياتها وحركاتها وحروفها وكلماتها ولا يترك منها شيء.
Mentioning, reciting all of its ayat, all of its words, all of its vowels and letters, and not leaving anything.
ثم يقرأ ما تيسر من القرآن.
And then after this, a person recites that which is easy from the Qur'an.
بلا استعاذة، تكفي الاستعاذة التي كانت قبل الفاتحة.
But a person doesn't need to say أعوذ بالله again.
لكن هل يبسمل إذا أراد أن يقرأ من أول أي سورة يبسمل، وإلا يقرأ مباشرة.
Should a person say Bismillah once again when reciting something from the Qur'an, if a person is starting a new surah or reading from the beginning of the surah, then he says Bismillah. Otherwise, just reads without saying Bismillah.
ثم يكبر مع رفع اليدين قائلا الله أكبر للركوع حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين كما صنع في تكبيرة الإحرام.
And then a person says Allahu Akbar, raising his or her hands, just in the same description as we mentioned previously, to the level of one's shoulders or the level of one's ear.
يقبض بباطن كفيه على ركبته.
And then a person goes down into bowing to ruku and he holds one's knees with the palms of his hands.
ولا يثني المرفقين يجعلهما ممدودة.
And a person doesn't bend the elbows, rather he keeps them straight.
وَاجْعَلَ الظَّهْرَ عَلَى اسْتِقَامَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ مَعَ الرَّأْسِ. نعم.
And the person makes sure that his back and his head is level.
ينظر دائما إلى موضع السجود في كل أوضاع الصلاة. نعم.
And throughout the prayer, throughout every position of the prayer, the person always looks at the place of sujood, the place of prostration.
ولا يلتفت لأن قلنا الالتفات إما أن يكون محرم أو مكروه.
And he doesn't move unnecessarily because we say the movement in the prayer is either haram, is impermissible or disliked.
يقول في ركوعه.
And whilst in his ruku' in the bowing, a person should say
سبحان ربي العظيم مرة واحدة وجوبا.
And a person has to say this, as the Shaykh recited, at least once as an obligation.
ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it's permitted for a person and it's recommended for a person to say it more than once, as it was narrated by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كان يقول
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, and the Shaykh will recite,
سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمَ الْمَرَّةَ الثَّانِيَ وَالثَّالِثَ وَهَكَذَا.
Either you should repeat the same statement two or three times.
أو يقول,
or say,
سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمَ وَبِحَمْدِهِ سُبُّوحٌ قُدُّوسُ رَبُّ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالرُّوحِ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ رَبَّنَا وَبِحَمْدِكَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي. ثم بعد هذا يكبر يرفع اليدين حال رفعه من الركوع مع قول سمع الله لمن حمده.
And then after saying this, as the person is rising up from the bowing and is saying سمع الله لمن حمده, at the same time raises his hand. So a person, he's getting up and saying سمع الله لمن حمده and raising his hands at the same time.
يخطئ بعض الناس يقول سمع الله لمن حمده إذا قام اعتدل, وهذا خطأ. يقول سمع الله لمن حمده مع رفع اليدين بين عندما يبدأ بالاعتدال إلى أن يعتدل. نعم.
So some people make a mistake that once they have stood up once again, then they say سمع الله لمن حمده. This is a mistake. Rather, a person should say سمع الله لمن حمده in the process of standing up and also at the same time raising their hands.
ثم إذا اعتدل يقول ربنا لك الحمد. ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه لربي الحمد لربي الحمد لربي الحمد وهكذا. نعم.
And once a person has completely stood up, has completely stood up and is straight, then he says ربنا ولك الحمد, and he can increase in this statement that which has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ثم بعد هذا يكبر بدون رفع اليدين ويسجد على الأعضاء السبعة, ولا بد أن يتحقق من أن الأعضاء السبعة كاملة على الأرض التي ذكرناها فيما تقدم. نعم.
And then a person goes down into sujood, goes down into prostration, and he doesn't raise his hands whilst doing this, and he makes sure that he prostrates on all of the seven limbs that we have mentioned. He makes sure that all of the seven limbs are touching the ground when he prostrates.
ويحذر من أن يضع المرفقين على الأرض.
And a person should be careful that whilst in the sujood, he doesn't place the elbows on the ground.
أو أن يرفع أحد رجليه.
Or that a person lifts up one of his legs or his feet.
وكذلك السنة أن يجافي أن يباعد بين أشياء ثلاثة.
And also the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is for a person to make some distance between three body parts.
بين الصدر والعضد, يعني هنا عند الإبط. نعم.
Firstly, for a person to make some distance between his chest and his arm like this.
وبين البطن والفخذ.
And also for a person to keep some distance between the stomach and the thigh.
وبين الفخذ والساق.
And also for a person to keep some distance between the thigh and the shins.
يعني لا ينضم ولا يمتد حتى يكون كالنائم. يعني لا يبالغ في المباعدة حتى يكون كالنائم للساجد ولا ينضم حتى يكون يعني في حالة يعني كصورة المتضايق. نعم.
So in all cases, a person shouldn't exaggerate. So a person doesn't roll up tight when making sujood, as if his person is very tight and close to each other, or close, the body parts are close to each other. And neither does a person extend all of his body parts as if it's sleeping on the front. Rather, a person remains, he does this moderately.
يقول في سجود مرة واحدة سبحان ربي الأعلى وجوبا ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد.
And whilst in the sujood, whilst in the prostration, a person says سبحان ربي الأعلى at least once as an obligation. And then a person can increase in this as has been narrated by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
ومواطن الدعاء في الصلاة موضعين.
And the times for a person to make a supplication in the prayer are two.
في السجود.
When a person is in the prostration, the sujood.
وقبل التسليم. أي بعد قراءة التشهد والصلاة الإبراهيمية. يدعو بما أحب والأولى أن يدعو بأدعية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنها أدعية جامعة مانعة. نعم.
So the first place in which a person should make the supplication in the prayer is the sujood. And the second place is after saying the tashahud and sending salutations and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad to the end of it. And before tasleem, then a person supplicates. And the best supplications are the supplications which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make, because they are the most comprehensive of supplications.
ثم بعد هذا يكبر دون رفع اليدين ويجلس. نعم.
من السجود.
نعم. Yeah.
And then after this, a person gets up from the prostration, saying Allahu Akbar, but without raising the hands, and sits down.
يفرش اليسرى ويجلس عليها. نعم.
So a person places the left foot down and sits on it.